Hey guys, it's Mark Perez, and welcome back to my FIFA 7 Halo Liverpool current mode where last month. We start off with our league games against Arsenal and Burnley, and despite both games being very interesting and very gripping games, I came away with 6 points. In this episode, I have a doubleheader against Spurs. First up against them again in the Capital One Cup, and then against them in the league. And it was pointed out to me that Liverpool's next Capital One Cup game is actually Spurs. So the game has given me a realistic fixture, because this is actually going to happen in real life. I don't know if that's going to be the team. Markovic can't play, and I don't know when Gomez is back fully from his injury. But a lot of those players could end up playing against Spurs in the cup. But yeah, doubleheader against Spurs. This should be interesting. First time in a official cup competition in our FIFA 17. Take a bit of a break from the Herald of League Football. The EFL Cup, it's called now. So, they gave up on that Capital One Cup shit pretty quick.
Yeah, an entertaining 4-2 victory that, and I can see them going on and getting another victory.
A lot of you probably are wondering why Lars Markovic is in the team. Simple, because as expected, some of the deadline day transfers and later in the window transfers aren't in the game. Like Mario Balotelli was with the squad, but still, when I started up this current mode. So, I actually made some profit on him, and funnily enough, and I actually ended up selling him to the same league, not to the same team. He went to the Marseille, actually, team I recently he got to know who better.
Beautifully to stroke it into the bottom left.
Good start to this match. Bit of a lucky break there by Lars Markovic. They happened to get in the way of Ilori's shot. Yes. And I put it in into the net. The deflection may have been what took it past this form. Who knows? Yeah, a few who non-regulars in the Spurs team for this cup match, but some of the regulars like Kyle Walker and Christian Eriksen. If Jansen up front instead of Harry Kane.
Free kick only from the referee.
Which is similar to Spurs in real life, but that is not by choice.
Signed for Bayern Munich.
That's for damn sure. And there's Son. He is on fire at the moment for Spurs.
there's some potential in this move. And the cross coming in. The shot's up! Oh, no scraps for the attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time.
You know what's hilarious? This is being recorded before. This is being recorded Saturday night. It's going up Monday. After the match has happened. So I don't know. By the time this goes up, we'll all know what happened between Spurs and Man City. But as of right now, I don't know. Yes! Yes! Jensen missed the penalty! He hit them on the counter! Alexander Arnold! Dio Sturridge! Oh, Wimmer did enough! Hang on, Shayojo! Oh! Oh! Gets a save out of Vorm. So from a penalty for Spurs to a corner for Liverpool. Oh.
Maybe the cross.
They kept it in, but they might not wish they might wish they hadn't. Hey, sir, just attempted a pass will scramble back to me. He hears Shay Ojo.
Lost his marker cleverly. Promising build up. Until that challenge. It's good work between these two.
Kyle Walker under pressure, but no. They gotta wait, no. Oh, Hagen was clubbing and headed it back. Danny Ings. Joe Gomez.
Spotted that well.
Oh, and cleared away again. And again, only to Ragnar Klavan. Here's Brannigan.
Here comes the cross.
Oops, in. Danny Ings! Oh, not good enough to be. He made a show of warm.
Nabil Bentaleb. Made the challenge well. Good forward play from them. This is an exercise in patience as they try to get an opening. A couple of options for him from the free kick, whether to go for goal or...
Oh, God damn it. Don't want any funny business from Spurs. First? Yes? This is the last for the counter-attack. Go, Lars! Go! Go! Go, 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 go! Yes? Yes? Ipsen in! Oh!
Corner here for Liverpool. Michel Vorm with a fabulous stop a few moments ago. That was top class.
Klavan! Oh, what a save from Vorm. Ragnar Klavan! I'll have another go and it wrinkles wide. Pochettino is probably wondering how that happened.
So it's 1-0 here.
No, wait, he'd be relieved that happened.
Well, time is ticking away. It's time for a change, and here it comes.
He's, seen enough of, Murray Mason for this tie. Of course, Murray Mason went to Holland in real life, so, it's another transfer that No. Done as it should be.
That's very good defending, and the player had nowhere to go. Sharply done to restart it here.
Done.
Is Danny Ings. It's a quick break.
Down to the team they want to re-sign. Wanna follow real life. I'm sure Hull will negotiate with Spurs. It's still out of time, the window is still open.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Dang. Sturridge! Did he get there? Did, but he's offside.
And there would have been a scoring opportunity.
You'll notice Daniel Sturridge is the captain of the second team. Oh, here comes Harry Kane. Probably wishing, Pochettino's probably wishing he had him on earlier when that penalty happened. Harry Kane might not have missed that. Brannigan. Come back to Brannigan. Markovic. So far has the only goal of the game. He whips it in. Sturridge is beat to Andy. And Spurs. Kind of clear, but it's still pulled by their box. There we go. Proper clear. And it's by Harry Kane. It's dispossessed, and so is Shea Ozha. Oh, with Alfred throw.
Play from his teammates. A lot of defenders between them.
Yes, Spurs are not messing around now. They are really going for it. Yeah, Eric Lamela just came up. Sturridge. Grinch! Oh, what's this? Oh, I can't do anything. Run again! For the bar!
Oh, just looking at the manager down in the technical area. He knows that that miss might be vital.
Doesn't even force a save out of Michel Vorm.
Here's Bentaleb. So let's have a look at the possession stats on the screen now. There they are.
Crazy stuff.
Even looking at the figures, not much to split these two sides.
Joe Gomez will deal with that. That's here's Lurie. Alexander Arnold.
Ings.
Hey, Ings. Here's Lars Markovic. Oh, Jan Vertonghen and did well. Oh, what you expect from a center defender of his quality. His son. And Arnold does his defensive duties as well. Hope to make sure son doesn't get a attack off. Now, I can counter. Here's Markovic. Whoops it in for Daniel Sturridge! 2-0! Oh, Daniel Sturridge has his first goal of the career mode. Oh, and the signature for celebration to go with.
It's not always easy to finish. Defenders caught out by it in the end. Well, he's a fantastic header of the ball, and his marker stood no chance there. Starting at 2-0.
Manager gets a lot of leeway. Hey, how have I not been punished for doing that? I thought the manager wasn't supposed to go on the pitch. Am I wrong about that?
Read the play well to intercept. Christian Eriksen.
Ings. Sturridge. Wall ball to Danny Ings. Ings, can he finish it off? Oh, Vorp did enough. His ankle. Oh, great! Oh!
Yeah, I thought he might have done better there. Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
Nothing went right in that scenario. That's overall, well, everything went right because as they pick up the 2-0, we'll win. Lars Markovic.
Close at times, but yeah, winners here.
Opener. Or added to by Daniel Sturridge. Gives me the victory and sees me through to the next round. If Liverpool can somehow manage to suit up and win over Spurs when they meet in the cup in real life, that'd be fantastic.
Aston Villa 1, Preston North End 2, Bury 1, Chesterfield 2.
Oh my breath. There goes Dave Van Halen.
Sunderland 1-4-3.
Bringing in new.
Who? Crystal Palace 2. Milton.
Who back up right back? So take some pressure off Nathaniel Clyne. As well as Alexander Arnold did that. Or he's not a right.
Arsenal 0. Northampton
back. But Calabria. Up here, he is. And he's a semi-decent looking one. He's only on loan because I just want to test him out before I commit to a purchase.
West Bromwich Albion 2, Brentford 3.
There's no future fee here. So I am taking a bit of a risk that so most might not sign him, but I guess that's a risk I'm willing to take. And I also made an offer for Dahoud. They are not interested in Brannigan. I don't think I have another midfielder that they might want. Unless they want Lucas. I guess I could skip Dela if they want Lucas. 15 million plus Lucas? It's either that or a straight up money deal. Looks like a straight-up money deal it is. Another English club looking to procure the signing of Lars Markovic. Not gonna happen. They aren't interested in Lucas. Okay, so money only. That's okay, I can do that. Let's have a feeler. 17 million. That's higher than his value, but it's not quite what my chief executive is suggesting. Almost forgot to switch back to the main team. Look at that! Not even. Very done relatively quickly. Squad rotation, I guess? He might reject that. Let's see. This is gonna be, I guess this can be like the first offer. Southampton came back with 12. Oh man, hey, we know you have money because we've given you so much. So up your offer or piss off. Yeah. The bigger role. So squad rotation isn't good enough. Let's try what he wants. 50k, 5 years, import first team player. That's the best you're gonna get, dude. I mean, I guess I could see him as someone I'll rotate with a... I mean... realistically, I'm looking for someone who will slot into that central midfield role if James Milner's reign starts to decline. Hopefully that won't happen. At least, not too soon anyway. But, I think that won't. Back at White Hart Lane yet again. And for her. Her. Undefeated. A madness? Why not? This time Premier League looking for 3 wins out of 3. In real life, the tie ended 1-1. But I might sound like a deluded fan, but I'm gonna say Liverpool should have won that match. We very sloppily, we didn't defend Danny Rose's shot, and we didn't put away the near enough chances. So hopefully I can rectify the mistake that the real life Liverpool made. Not getting 3 points against Spurs, who are still without
looking to provide width.
Lloris. It's weird.
Big reshuffle for Liverpool.
Maybe because of all the saves were pulled off, or maybe Lloris is injured.
Milner starts with Emre Can, and he headed it goal.
That would be a big blow to us, bro. There's a top 4 and even title hopes if that were to happen. I know everyone is saying in real life their hopes are really dashed by having Harry Kane being injured. But imagine if they didn't have Hugo Lloris. No offense to Michel Warm, he's a very good goalkeeper, but having a good goalkeeper like a Hugo Lloris is always going to be a really big help.
Could be dangerous. He's taken on his man and beaten him. Well, that's a good clean tackle to stop the attack. It goes out wide again.
Here's Roberto Firmino, who scored, who, as I said, I'm recording this on Saturday. Firmino scored the equalizer in today's very lucky win over Swansea. I'm not ashamed to admit it was purely in a spot of luck, but that's,
well, we're gonna get a look at
Liverpool. That's okay. We can all do a bit of luck from time to time. Like matches, I don't know if you guys have the app Crowd Scores. It's an app that like keeps you updated on scores, numbers and such. And you can follow all sorts of different games, and you can talk to other football fans on it. I was looking through the comments after Liverpool's victory, and I saw a good bunch of Manchester United fans like, "Oh, you're gonna need to penalty the referee pay off referees to give you penalties and stuff like that, and to beat us and stuff like that." And I'm like, "Are you for fucking real? You support Manchester United. You don't even get a say in this conversation." With the amount of bullshit decisions Manchester United have gotten over the years? Oh, hell no, you not. You completely. That's not the pot calling the kettle black. That's the freaking kettle calling another kettle a kettle. Seriously. It's completely fucking idiotic. Yeah, Liverpool got lucky. How many times? How many times over her dominating years? And I'll admit many I had dominating years, but over that many years, how many lucky times? How many times did Man United get lucky? Hello? You know why they call it Fergie time? It may as well be AKA the time Man United get fucking lucky and be off their ass. Yes. Seriously. Man United is Archer. Wait. Just true. Those idiot Man United fans who said those comments, and for some reason you're watching, you should take shame that you are even starting that discussion. Your nice glass house, you just pretty much threw a fucking boulder at it. Yes. I could have started a conversation with these guys, like saying, you support Manchester United, you have no opinion on luck. Like, your whole team is pretty much this big. Your team has gotten lucky so many times already. It's almost like your second name. If you weren't referred to as Manchester United, you'd be referred to as Luckychester United.
In the middle. The defender got there first, though.
Which sounds crap, I realize, but seriously. And it's not just Manchester United fans. Every team gets lucky. Every team gets lucky. And it wasn't even luck for the penalty. It was a penalty. Ask anyone. That's a penalty. Firmino got pushed to the floor. Or Rangel. Well, even Rangel realized his mistake. That's why he got angry. Because he realized his mistake. When the referee blew for the penalty. After he committed that foul, I bet in his head he was like, oh no. What have I done? That's going to be a penalty. And sure enough, it was, and James Milner put it away.
Time now.
So, yeah, every team gets lucky. But Manchester United fans, you do not even get a conference. UK. You need to start a legitimate conversation calling some other team out for being lucky. Don't even start that bullshit. Okay? Let's
Coutinho.
Cause don't make me fucking laugh. Do not make me fucking laugh.
Well, here comes the support. Milner.
Alaba.
That's a Chadley.
And the best ball.
That's Chadley.
Oh. Nah. Probably deserve to lose it.
And got it back again.
Spurs.
It's Tottenham who are going to make the change.
Dele Alli. Head to left. Who should be at Schalke. Yeah. So another transfer. Isn't done.
Walker. Nabil Bentaleb.
Origi. Oh, just as I was about to pass it, it Jan Vertonghen stuck his Belgian foot.
Nudge you in the direction.
Hit in to prevent it from happening.
They'll be facing Stoke City.
Alaba! Oh, imagine! That would have been a hell of a announce your presence in the Premier League. A goal. Score few goals with my defend wide wing backs X in the previous FIFA. Well, Ricardo Rodriguez and Nathaniel Klein. Of course, this year it's Nathaniel Klein and David Alba. Firmino whips it. Origi! He sliced it! Oh my god, that is a horrible... That's horrible, Mesty Buck. I think that says it all, that this is not going to be D-Rock's day. He's not having the best time out there against Spurs. Ooh, I thought Manny was going to warrant a mistake there from Vorm. Here's Origi. Chan. Origi! Sadio Mane! Doubles! This is the tally, and doubles his... his tally as well. D-Rock Origi, fuck! He got a stroke of, ironically, luck. And Sadio Mane was in the right place at the right time. And Pochettino can't believe it! 6 goals already from Sadio Mane. Hey.
And it's Liverpool.
Looks like Spurs are bringing on a substitute. As I bring on Daniel Sturridge for his first Premier League appearance of the season.
Just widen the margin here.
This is where I saw a Spurs player get off their bench. Maybe he was just going to warm up, because it doesn't look like anyone came on.
Coutinho.
For that.
Some potential in this move.
Mane.
That's a corner now for Liverpool.
Where's the corner? Or by putting the pressure on Kyle Walker and Michel Vorm.
Matip!
Oh! Straight at Vorm.
Spotted that well and intercepted. Walker. Now he's got the ball. What's he going to do with it?
Milner. Now Sturridge is offside.
Didn't need to go as soon as he did that.
Miles offside.
Bringing on a new
play. Mason going off for Christian Eriksen. Not sure why he didn't start. That was an odd one. I mean, yeah, he didn't have the best game against us in the cup, but neither did Ryan Mason, to be honest.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of 3 minutes.
David Alaba.
Alaba. Emre Can. Firmino.
Klein. And that's a win confirmed for Liverpool.
Oh, it's the full-time whistle. I was wondering what happened. I just saw them all stop. I was like, is it a corner? Is it a free kick? Nope. 2 goals from Sadio Mane. Hey, dude. Who give me a 2-0 win, and I go 3-for-3 in the Premier League.
Bournemouth 2.
Yeah.
Stoke City 1.
And I will end that episode here.
Leicester City 1, Swansea City 3.
Tottenham Hotspur.
Because there's the deadline day is coming up, and I don't want to bore you all with that stuff. So yeah. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
In fourth, Bournemouth with 7 points. In fifth, Manchester United with 6 points. In sixth, Stoke City with 5 points. In seventh, Everton.